Saturn is unique. Unlike the other 8 planets in our solar system, yes, Pluto counts to me, Saturn has one thing going for it that the others are lacking. Rings! Beautiful multicolored rings. They make the 6th planet from the sun a cosmic marvel. But how and why are they there? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, why does Saturn have rings? Before we take off into this video, I just want to ask you guys to leave me your comments down below. Okay, Saturn, you big old planetary babe, what have you got for us? Well, okay, something that I said at the beginning of this video isn't actually true. While Saturn certainly boasts the most impressive array of rings, it isn't actually the only planet in our hood with them. It seems that Neptune, Jupiter, and Uranus have rings. Oi oi. Jupiter's rings, for example, were only discovered in 1979 by NASA's Voyager 1, and they're very thin and dark, unlike Saturn's big bright ice rings that have been the center of much discussion for hundreds of years. Now, I don't want you to get too excited straight away, but the subject of Saturn's rings is still much debated in the astrological world. Even our mates at NASA don't have a definitive answer as to why they're there, but we do have a few pretty big clues. You may have spotted a common denominator between the 4 planets with advertised rings here. Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune are 4 gas giants. There are only gas giants. Gas giant. These likely tell us something about the way gravity on these huge planets influences their surroundings. While we know a little more about Jupiter's very faint rings, Saturn's big boys have been the source of fascination and deliberation since they were first observed by Galileo Galilei in 1610. Since then, we have discovered Saturn has 7 groups of rings made up of thousands of smaller rings. 4 of the group of 7 stand out as being bigger than the other 3, and each are separated by gaps that scientists are calling divisions. 401 years after Galileo first observed Saturn's rings, American astrophysicist Robin Cannot posed a new theory on the planet's ring formation. This theory is widely considered to be the most credible suggestion to date. Now, she says that Saturn's rings are icy remains of an old, smashed up moon. She thinks this moon formed billions of years ago, but got too close to the planet to uphold a stable orbit, and instead was sucked too close to Saturn, its gravity ripping it apart and unraveling its icy outer layers into the prominent rings that we have in orbit today. She thinks the rocky core of the moon then likely smashed into Saturn. As for the 5% of Saturn's rings that aren't icy, it is thought that this is space dust. This could be made up of meteorites that have hurtled towards Saturn over the years. Her theory is largely supported by NASA's Larry Esposito. While this theory does seem to explain the inner rings of Saturn, the space probe Cassini, which studied the planet from 2004 to 2017, suggested that the outer ring, the E-ring, is made from ice silicates, carbon dioxide, and ammonia from cryocolanic plumes. So basically, this is volcanic matter from Enceladus, Saturn's 6th largest moon. This could explain why Saturn's rings are observed to be different colors. They're actually made up from different parts of icy matter. While Cassini plunged into Saturn in 2017, it did manage to skirt the inner rings and send a lot of data back to Earth, which is still being deciphered today. While scientists don't have the answer yet, it is thought that the key to understanding the group formation of the rings comes from studying the planet's Roche limit. Now, the Roche limit is the distance in which a space object can get to a planet without its own mass being sucked into the planet's gravity. It seems that Saturn's ring positions are determined by the space matter's Roche limit, although some of the planet's moons do fall amid the rings, no doubt having their own gravitational effect. Final fact for you, while Saturn is the most ringalicious planet in our solar system today, it is suspected that Mars will one day become a ringed planet too. Its moon, Phobos, is slowly being drawn closer to the red planet. In tens of millions of years, like the suspected events that caused Saturn's iconic rings, Phobos would likely be torn apart by Mars's gravity and form a ring of debris around our neighbor. So there we have it, not a definitive answer, but an answer using the best available information as to why Saturn has rings. Sadly, it doesn't seem like Earth will be getting ringy with it anytime soon, which makes me kinda sad. If you guys like this video and you want more space content, then please do leave this video with a thumbs up. Also, why not leave me a comment letting me know why you think that Saturn has rings? Are they a conspiracy theory? Are they really there? Also, let me know what your favorite planet is. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next video. But for now, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.